Hi everyone! The new version of VSDC Video Editor has a lot of powerful features to impress you, but the top of it all is probably our new Chroma Key effect. Chroma Key is still available in both free and pro versions of VSDC. The pro users, however, do get a bit of advantage here because their Chroma Key has an HSL color space. If you're wondering how it works and what the benefit is, stay tuned, you're about to find out! Create a new project and import your footage. Then add a background remover effect. If you are using a free version, by default you get the YUV background remover mode. However, if you are a pro user, the default background remover mode is HSL. Let's take a look at the difference between the two modes. First, let's remove the background using the free mode. It may work for some footage, but in our case, if you zoom in, you'll see that the edge looks uneven, and it will certainly affect the quality. So let's go ahead and switch to the HSL mode. Use the eyedropper tool to select the color you want to remove from the video. It's better to do it that way because the default bright green color may not always coincide with the background color in your video. Moving on to the settings. There are three groups of settings here. The first group includes processing mode. You can turn hardware acceleration on and off here. Mode allows you to select the processing mode. Output allows you to activate the chroma key mask. And chroma key color is self-explanatory. The second group of settings is the chroma key color parameters. Let's slow down here a little bit. The color detection will be happening based on three parameters: hue, lightness, and saturation. When you use the eyedropper tool, you select a very specific color from the palette. However, when it comes to background remover, you can't rely on that. Because as you know, each color can have multiple shades in your video. It can be bright or dim, saturated or pale. So what you want to do instead is define a spectrum of shades with multiple hue values, maximum and minimum lightness and saturation values. The third group of settings contains post-production filters. The maximize filter increases the chroma key effect on the border of the object and a little bit around it. The minimize filter reduces the chroma key effect on the border of the object. Median filter helps you make the border smoother. And blur filter defines how blurred the border will be. Going back to practice. We've selected the chroma key color using the eyedropper, right? Now let's find hue delta and type 0. Next, we are going to start tweaking this parameter to set the minimum color shade that would remove most part of the background. The following step will be to find maximum hue delta, set the same value you've set for the hue delta before, and start increasing it until you get to the point where you're happy with the result. Got it? First you set the minimum value, then you set the maximum range, and it's typically 2 times higher than the minimum. Repeat these steps with the remaining parameters. Lightness delta, maximum lightness delta, saturation delta, maximum saturation delta, If you'd like to see how much work you've just performed, use the Reduce Contrast option. It allows you to change chroma key opacity level. Since we've finished dealing with shades, lightness, and saturation, let's move on to the next step. Post-processing. If you still see a green border around the object, use the Maximize filter or the Minimize filter. After changing the border parameters, you can go back to the main settings and fine-tune image rendering at any moment. Let's take a closer look at the border again. If it's still a bit choppy and uneven, we recommend using the median filter to make it smoother. The blur filter can also come in handy here. To top it off, we suggest using the hue, saturation, and lightness effect from the adjustments menu. Just select green in the properties window on the right-hand side, or place points in the right part of the color spectrum, then reduce saturation. Just don't overdo it, unless you want a black and white video. And this is it! If you have any questions about the new version, leave them in the comments below. Give us the thumbs up if you liked this tutorial, and remember to subscribe.